I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter.
Hey everybody. I'm going to start building my stabilizer rig, or at least a stabilizer rig, a different one. And I want to be able to add accessories to it. And so I've been looking for cheap and frugal ways to be able to add different accessories to the stabilizer rig, since the whole thing's going to be made out of PVC like everybody else is doing. I've made a couple of these in the past, but I kind of want to make one that's a little bit more permanent. And by permanent, I mean one that's I'm going to use all the time instead of every once in a while. Well, maybe not all the time, but it's going to be one I use. So what I actually have here is a T-Mobile MyTouch 3G slide phone box. This is what my daughter's phone came in a while ago. Just a regular old plastic box. A nice little rubber on the corners. Not too big, big enough for the foam. Came with some foam on the inside. I took it all out. But what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go through and prepare this to be utilized. So I've got some blue tape, and I have a piece of sandpaper, which I dropped. Let's see if I can grab it without knocking over the tripod. There we go. Some nice 400 grit sandpaper, about half a sheet. My intention is to basically rough this all up to where it'll hold new paint. Because I could leave it like this, but I really don't want to. I kind of want to give it its own little paint flavor, if you will. So I'm going to sand it. And the stickers actually came off really easy. So, that's just something. So, you know, little accessories, if you will. Accessorize my rig. So, it should be pretty easy. I'm just going to go through with this little sandpaper here. And see how bad it is. Take it to all the edges. The reason why I'm sanding it down before I paint it is it's nice, shiny, glossy plastic. And if you're going to paint, especially using something like Rust-Oleum, it needs to have a little bit of a tooth. So if you use something like 400, you can just kind of knock some of the gloss off of it and it'll give it a tooth. And the tooth is basically just having a rough surface so the paint can stick. I'm using 400 because this is kind of soft plastic. And it's coming along pretty good. If you're going to do something like this, sand it down the direction you're going to paint it. When I paint it, I'm going to go back and forth this way. So I'm going to go lengthwise. So I'm going to sand it lengthwise. If I do circles, it's going to make swirls and probably not going to help so much. So all I'm doing is just kind of roughing it to get a little bit of a grip. So when I paint, it's actually going to stick. So hit the shiny spots. The whole goal, no shiny spots. No shiny. I don't know if you can see that or not. I got the light. Probably the whole thing looks shiny. You see what I'm saying? No shiny. Those little shiny spots, they need to go away. So I'm going to kind of pause this and you know, sand it up real good. You don't need to hang around for that. I'll be back and you'll be like, ooh, look at that. Okay, so it took me about 2 minutes to go through and kind of rough this up pretty good. It still has a little bit of shine. But most of the shine is knocked off of it. The 400 grit didn't really score the plastic surface per se, but it did remove a lot of the clear, which is kind of what I'm looking for. This is going to be the bottom. So, I mean, I care, but I don't really care quite that much about it. I do want to kind of preserve the black because it's rubbery. I think it's going to look pretty cool on my rig. So what I'm going to do, utilize this. And the good thing is that I can actually tape over the seam because it's very shiny, the little seam right here, and the seam on this end. So I'm just kind of looking at a couple pieces of tape. So the blue tape is going to peel off real nice and easy when I can never find the beginning of it. Where are you? There it is. Yes. So what I'm going to do, I like to kind of preload my tape, makes it easier. That way I can always rip off what I want and what I don't want. I'm actually going to go through with some tape, cover the whole thing. I'm going to pay attention to the edges and tape it up real good. So, be back in a minute. Well, I got the box taped off. What I'm going to do at this point is come back with a little razor blade, and I want to trim out all the corner pieces and get all the excess tape off. That way I have a much cleaner area there, so when I go through and apply the paint to it, it's going to be, you know, only on the silver and not on the rubber. So let me see if I can find, there we go. I'm going to use my trusty Gerber knife. Had this knife for about 14 years. My dad gave it to me. So very nice. Look at that. Sweet, nice little point. That's what I'm going to use. I'll be back. Okay, so after a while with my little knife there, kind of trimming up the edges, here's kind of what we're left with. So all this will be a new Rust-Oleum hammered silver color, and this remains the black rubber. So it just took a little while. So next step, this is going to be painting. So I don't think you guys want to see that. I'll be back. I don't know. You want to see it? Yeah, I'll paint. See if I can paint with one hand. All right, we'll give it a whirl. All right, we're outside, kind of windy. I'm going to try to paint. This is the bottom side of it. Shake it up. Give it a little test. Oh, yeah. Light dusting. My dog. Sorry about that. I don't think you've seen half of that. I'm paying more attention to what I'm spraying, what I'm filming. Also trying to be downwind. Or upwind, sorry. Because what I'm going for is that hammered aluminum look. So you kind of lay it on. Kind of thick and then let it dry. That's the side opening box. There's the other side. There. I'll let that dry into the top. We'll see what it looks like. All right. We're into the front real quick. Well, since we've already done the back. Let's see. I don't know if you can see that, but whenever you use the Rust-Oleum hammered paint, or the hammered series paint, it kind of adds texture to it, so it almost looks like aluminum, like metal. And that's kind of what I wanted. It's got a little bit of texture. And I'm gonna set this back down. It's kind of cold out here now. I'm going to want the MyTouch logo to go away. So what I actually have to do is do a dusting first. And by dusting, I mean a little squirt. If you're going to use this stuff, you need to dust it from a distance. That way you get more texture, if that's what you're going for. So just a little fat coat. I'll do it from up here. I'm trying to get where you can see it. That little splatter is what's going to give it the texture I'm looking for. And I'll kind of angle it out this way too. The wind's blowing a little bit. Let me wait and let the wind stop. Let's try it this way.
All right.
I've kind of built up a little bit of texture just by kind of doing a little dusting from a distance. So all this stuff is going to look like texture. And I want to do just a little bit where the MyTouch logo is so it goes away. Yeah. It's going to look like metal. So my last coat, I'll do just like I would regular spray paint, and it'll lay down on top of it, and it'll help build a little bit of volume, and that volume will make it stand out to where it'll actually look more like hammered aluminum. So, apologize for the wind. This should be it. Get the whole thing, one more time, whole thing. See that pop up there? That's nice. That's what I'm looking for. Just like that. That hammered look. Once you see it kind of pop up like that, you're done. Just let it dry. Where's my dog going? Let him go. Watch this. See if he does it. Get it! Get it! Yeah, he's like, I don't know what to get. Let's see if I do it again. He's looking for something to get. Go get it! He really has no idea what he's going to look for. He's just going. Okay, anyway. There he goes. Get it! Yeah. Hard to tell. It's getting kind of dark. But you'll be able to see when I bring it inside. It's going to be pretty cool. All right, well, we're back inside. And the paint's still really wet, but I want to kind of show you what I was going for. You see that? I don't know if you can see it or not. I'm having a hard time seeing myself. But with the Rust-Oleum hammered aluminum, when you do the dusting to sort of build up the volume, you'll get to a point where you hit one good spray on it, and this is what it turns into. Can you see that? All that's paint texture. So now this plastic box pretty much looks like almost like aluminum, like a galvanized aluminum box, which is kind of what I was going for. I don't really have a lot of texture on the sides. That's where I opened, so it's kind of thin. But on the where I opened the box, but on the top, this is what I was going for. Man, I really hope you guys can see that. Let me see. Maybe if I put it under the light a little bit, it's probably pretty full of glare full. But hopefully you can see it. But yeah, this is, I like this paint a lot, man. And the black's pretty good, but this is the aluminum. Or actually, I'm sorry, it's the either aluminum or hammered silver. I think it might just be hammered silver. But yeah, that's the kind of look I'm going for with the box, the equipment box that's going to go on the back of the stabilizer rig. So, yeah, look at that. No more MyTouch logo. Looks almost like a purpose-made equipment box. I didn't do a lot of texture on the bottom. But I really wanted it to kind of stand out on top. So, the only thing I'd love to do is just to kind of let it dry, so I'm going to pick a little platform for this thing to sit on, like this little nut right here, and I'll set it on top of the nut, just like that, and pretty much I'll come back in maybe about 2 hours and I'll peel the tape off and you'll have the contrasting black rubber and then the aluminum or the hammered aluminum look. So it should be pretty cool. But yeah, that's going to go on the back of my stabilizer rig. So I figured I'd do each part of the video to make the stabilizer rig separately, and then I'll probably do a short one. But yeah, I really dig that paint. So look at that. Very nice. Slightly excited by this. Yes. Yep. Well, it's really been about 10 minutes. I was going to wait a couple hours, but I decided not to. So, see what happens here. There we go. All right. Paint's still wet. Got the nice little edges on it. Little rubber edged box. The rubber's a little dusty. I can always clean that up a little bit, but yeah. Check it. Nice textured. Looks like it's metal. It's not. It's plastic. It's very light. Pretty cool. Not too bad. It looked good enough. Especially when I clean it up. Got nice little metallic edges going on. Nice little aluminized, hammered silver slash aluminum finish. Yeah. Already had the paint. Box came from a phone, so pretty slick. Yes. I'll just let it dry. I'll come back and get it in a couple days. It'll be good to go. Doesn't take that long to dry, but I'm not going to get anything done for another couple days anyway. So it can dry and harden all it needs to. This stuff usually dries fairly quickly. About 4 hours, man, it's done. It'll slowly harden up over time, but you know, realistically, you can paint something and 20 minutes later, you're kind of finished. You can just kind of set it aside. Dries in a couple hours. Great stuff.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut